Well, it looks like I made it for another beautiful sunset. That is actually Lake Minnehaha. I know it sounds odd, but it's the I'd call it a sister lake to make Lake Mineola. Just standing on a hill here in Claremont with the setting sun behind me, and it's a pretty good day. Just out running errands for my wife. You know, a day late here with the pie shirt. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm wearing my pie shirt today instead of yesterday, which was, you know, National Pie Day or whatever. And just here in this construction area, and decided to stop and film the sunset. I don't know. It's pretty cool. It's not really, you can barely see it, how it's kind of touching the very bottom now. It's pretty cool. Anyway. Okay, I just watched my video and you couldn't see my pie shirt, so maybe now you can. There it is. Pie shirt for National Pie Day. Anyway, the sun is just about set. I don't know if you can still see it. Let's see if I can get it to, there it is. It's about halfway gone. Yeah, I made it here, you know, pretty much just right on time. Well, I've gone from the sunset to the moon there. It looks like it's a little bit more than halfway. I believe it's getting fuller. I believe that's the way it's going. Not quite sure. Not up on my lunar charts. but that's pretty good. I'm using the Rebel a T2i Canon. I have the Magic Lantern software installed on it, and I'm using the Rode microphone, a video mic, and I haven't cropped it. I know there's a crop mode where I can zoom in really closer, but I've got the 300 millimeter lens. I think it's a 75 to 300 millimeter lens on, so it looks pretty good. You can definitely see it moving. Either that or my tripod's moving, but no, I believe it's the Earth rotating. Okay, as you can see, I'm using the Canon Rebel T2i in the crop mode on the camera. Still using the EF 75 to 300 millimeter lens. Still using the Rode microphone, Magic Lantern software on the Canon to kill the automatic gain control, the thing that everybody hates. But it's pretty good. You can see the moon drifting by there. It's a little off-centered, but I think that's how I have it set up. I don't think it's yeah, you can see some pretty good craters on that. That's you know, it's not telescope quality, but that's pretty good. So, just wrapped up uploading all the moon footage I took with the Canon, and I think it turned out pretty good. Still have to work on some of the you know, finer points, like actually centering the moon so it's not all cut off on the side, and stuff like that. Got about 3 or 4 lenses with the Canon now. A couple ones I had with my the film Canon Rebel. Now that I have the digital, you know, they're interchangeable. They're not
they're not stabilizing lenses like the ones that came with the Canon, but they're pretty good lenses. You know, the 75 to 300 one that I used to shoot the moon, shoot the moon. I had, you know, purchased earlier for the film camera, and was happy to you know, be able to use it with the new one. That's why, you know, I went with the Canon instead of the any of the other brands, because I already had a Canon. So lenses are expensive, and if you can reuse them on other cameras, it's always good to have. Other than that, I guess I have to work tomorrow. Didn't think I was gonna have to, but you know, over time, it's always a good thing. Other than that, I don't know. So I guess I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.